Hi friends, welcome to Sweenu Technologies. Myself Ram Kumar. Today we'll discuss on Object Studio and Blue Prism. So in last week, previous sessions, right? So we have seen what are the basic skills to create a process actually, and then what are the data items, some stages, how to run a process, how to validate a process, right? And then some controlling place, breakpoints, collections, loops, how a page reference is taken, what is stepping, and then how we can step through pages, and how we can run a process from control room. So we have not covered the stages, all stages, but we'll be covering step by step. So this is the basic idea you might have got right now. So let's jump on to the next important component in Blue Prism, that is Object Studio, right? So Object Studio, where this is the place where the application is mapped or treated as an object, right? So in as part of this Object Studio, just we will learn about what is the objective, how we can create a business object, right? And then what is application modular, and then so what are the stages which are not there in Process Studio and there which are in Object Studio. So we will see the specific or exclusive stages which are available only in Object Studio. We will go through them, and then so we have seen some flow actually, right? So how we are using a page reference, how the flow or hierarchy is going on. So we will see similarly in Process Studio what are pages called, or is the concept of pages or not, right? We will see that in Object Studio how it is represented, and then we will see one important stage which is action stage. So through this stage only we will be able to use the object, right, as part of our process. So we will get started quickly so that we will understand one by one, right? So what is our objective now? So we need to explore this Object Studio to see how it provides an interface to an application by creating a business object using different stages, right? So what I mean to say is every application, it can be a browser, it can be an Excel, it can be Outlook, whatnot, any desktop based or mainframes or .NET stuff or any Java based or any browser, anything is treated, one application is treated as one object. So when we are dealing with different applications from Blue Prism, so we need to map one object per application. This you can take it as a thumb rule, one object, one application, right? So we will see how we can do this, followed by we will see how to create a business object. So we have seen how to create a process, right? So we will see how to create a business object, means how we can name it, and then how we should need to map to an application, right? So we will see the steps actually there, and then we will see how we can name it, and then once it is created, so what are the default pages which are available? If you see the Process Studio, we have seen main page is the default one, right? But here we will be having three. I will explain why are three pages available here in object, that we will see when we are seeing the tool, right? So we will go through this, and then next we will go through what is an application modeler, right? Means how it looks like, means what is it visit, how it looks like, what is it used, means Object Studio, we are creating a business object, and what is this application modeler doing inside it. So you will get to know once we are in the tool, right? So I will explain that, and then we will see how to add some elements. You will understand by seeing the tool what is an element I am seeing by, and then identify means spying. So means we will be doing something called spying, through which we will understand the downstream application which we are trying to interact with, right? And then we will see what are the, when we are doing a spying, means when we are trying to understand an application, what are the attributes read by the software, Blue Prism software, and then what are the attributes which are captured in it, and then we will see that under the application modular, okay? And then how to highlight, means we have interacted with different sections in a web browser, for example, so we want to highlight it, means what is that we are trying to reach, and what is attach and detach, right? And then finally launch, means launching an application, so on. So let's go on to the tool first, and then we will see how we can create an object first, and then we will go on this kind of application modular, what are the stages, specific stages, right? We will go one by one, right? So let's go back to the tool now. So here is our studio. So if you see here, we have created one process earlier, and then that process is also published. I think you hope you remember how we have published a process. Now we will go to objects. So for the same process will follow. So I will say right click and then create object. So this will open a small wizard where you need to give the what is the object name you want to give. So I want to give some name as browser Google. So this is the name of the object which I want to do, and then it will ask us a description, browser application access Google Finance. So this is our description. This object is created for accessing the Google Finance page through a browser. That is the intent here. Okay, and then I am saying finish. So once I say finish, it will create the object for us, and then it is highlighted if you see. So I will do a double click, and then the Object Studio is getting opened. So this is what is Object Studio. I think the same grid, start and everything will be the same, but there are some, the implementation will change, which will be understanding one by one. So we have something called initialize, cleanup, action. So if you see here, initialize and cleanup, start and end are actually connected already. For cleanup also start and end is connected, but for action one is not connected. So this is what you can give a name. Action one you can rename, but cleanup and these two are cannot be renamed. Okay, so we should not rename also. So these are something like thing that you want to start with a process object where you want to, before accessing any browser or something, you want to do some cleanup. Means already existing browsers, you want to close it off first so that there is no confusion, right? That is called, means before accessing the application, you are trying to do some setup, or you want to go to some default page and then stay there and then give some values to it. So initialize is a part where we will do some kind of pre-preparations before we are accessing the actual application, right? So to the vice versa is cleanup. So once the application access is over, you want to clean up some things, you want to delete some things, you want to release some local variables which are not there. So you will do in cleanup. So by default, these are not mandatory to do. So if you are intending to do that, you can, this is the placeholder which I am trying to say. Okay, so these are the placeholders which are already there, so that initialize means before starting up or interacting with the application, you want to set up something, you want to formalize something, you want to initialize something. So this can be done in initialize. And then cleanup. Cleanup is, this can be used when you want to do some cleanup activities, right? So what you would understand is, when you are calling action one or the page which you rename, so thing that you will rename it as the one which you are trying to use. So finance data. So this is the page name I am saying. So get. So there is difference between, so I am giving a verb name here. Get finance data means this object is trying to do some task. What is the task? We want to get the finance data, Google finance data, from a browser. So that's what my intention is. So this, the action names or pages which we are calling here, so these are called actions actually. So inside an object, the tabs which are there all are called as actions. So initialize is an action, cleanup is an action, get finance data is an action, and so on and so forth. But in Process Studio, we have something called pages. Each is a page, a process is a page, right? A process will have multiple tasks, but here this is one task we are grouping into one action, and then we can use this from Process Studio. We will see how we can do that, right? So this is how we create just an object, and then this is the purpose of initialize, cleanup. We will get into this more detail when we are taking up other use case further, right? So this is just the Google Finance thing. So next we should understand, if you see here, there is something called application modular. So if you go back to my previous statements, what I was saying, one object will interact with one application, one-to-one mapping, right? So in that case, how this application modular is useful? So when think that a browser we have a browser where there is a placeholder where we type the URL. There is a place where we say submit or refresh buttons, and then once the page is loaded, we will be getting different sections of page, right? So when we are trying to get a finance data or some, we want to read some HTML data on a browser, we should understand from where the data should be. So we have so many sections in a HTML page, but we want a particular section data. So we need to identify what is the section, we need to identify where is the browser URL and then type it, right? So this application modeler is where, so this will be acting as an interface between the application and the object. So we are calling, we are saying one application is an object, means the browser is an application in which Google Finance data is there, what not, we have anything in the browser, right? So those all are treated as an application. It means application is doing some task, means object is doing some task for us. How it is doing is, application model is the mediator or the interface where it will capture the attributes which are required to identify a specific element. If you go, so if you remember to the slide, we said add element, right? Add element is this, in the sense, example, where we type the browser URL, that is an element. Where we submit a registration form, that is an element. Where we type our input, our name, or we select any country name. So these all are elements which are there on the application. So those element details are captured into the application modular. So when we say that get finance data, this task is run. So what will happen is, it will try to get the data through this application modular. Means it will go and hit the browser URL, it has to type the URL, right? Where it will write? So the data is stored in application modular, where it will say, okay, go and click here, go and do this. So application modular is the having the data of the application, and then object will try to access the application through this application modular. Okay, so hope you understood, but still if you are confused or if you are not having enough understanding, we will go through this one by one step, and then you can clearly understand what we are trying to do, right? So simple, I will just see, so we will just open how we can map this application module or fill the application modular. So when we are seeing this, if you see here, is this a new application modular? Yes, the application name is browser Google, the name which we have given earlier, same thing, right? I'm saying next. So this is a new thing which we want, we don't want to use an existing one. So that can also be done. So I said next. If you see here, these are the types of applications the Blue Prism is supporting. Means, is it window based, is it Java based, is it browser based or mainframe based? What we are doing now? Yes, we are going with browser based now. So window based examples are Outlook, Excel, right, calculator. All which are installed inside it, right? This browser is separate. So we are going this browser based. Next, if you see here, a browser which is already running or the browser that is launched from an executable file. So these are the two modes we have in the browser. So I want to launch it separately. I don't want to use an existing one, right? So next, and then it defaultly picks up IE Explorer, which is already installed on this machine. So I am taking it, and then what is the start page you want? Means if you want to, example, there might be as an example, once the browser is opened, you want to, by default Google should be there, by default Rediff should be there, by default Yahoo should be there. So you can decide on these things. So you can give the URL of the start page. So I don't want to give anything here. And then, so Java implementation is not required, HTTP complex exclude is not required as of now, but I will just tell you what is its purpose later point of time. At this point, we will concentrate on how we can create a application modular. So I said next. If you see here, by default we have got this. So this is the application modular wizard where we can add elements and then see what is there. Okay, so first we need to start with, so what we do to a browser, what we do first, we launch the browser and then we type the URL. So already we have said this is the IE Explorer is the browser for me. So when I say launch here, it should launch an IE browser. So let's see, I clicked on launch. If you see here on the background, there is an browser launched, right? So I was telling you, right, so this everything is an element for this. So what is the starting element? We should give an element. So what we'll do is browser input. So we should follow some notation better. So I will say it's an input box, right? What is that? Browser URL. So this is my where we give the browser URL, that is an input, right? This is the element which we want to capture now. So if you see here in the PPT, we are saying something about we need to do something called identify. Identify is nothing but you need to map the attributes of the input browser URL input to the application modular so that this can be used by object in turn, right? So if you see here, there is something called identify on the right side bottom. So I'm clicking on identify in the center. So once I click on identify, if you see here, there is a mode called HTML. So when I'm hovering it, is going to the other side. So this is the mode which we will use actually. So as it is a browser, we have to use HTML mode. Okay. So this is what I'm doing, and then what I'm doing is I am just trying to highlight what it is there. If you see here, above blank is not getting highlighted. So I will try to click on Alt. So when I click on Alt, it is Win32 mode. It's a window mode. Okay. So what I'm trying to do is using this window mode, I am able to identify. So we have to switch on through these modes so that you identify this thing. So the reason being, so HTML is there inside the browser, means once the page is getting loaded in this body of the body where we call something called body part of a browser, there HTML data is there. But the input where we enter the URL, it's not a HTML based. So it's a window based thing. So that's why it is highlighting now when we are having Windows 32 mode. So how we can select that is, you have to place the cursor on the section where you want to add it as an element. Press the control key and then do a left click. So I'm doing a left click now. So done. So wait for a moment. If you see, application module is getting highlighted. So I just highlighted now. So if you see here, these many attributes are captured. If you see here. So in the PPT, I'm saying, I highlighted what are the elements which are, so by default, what will happen is the Blue Prism is having some intelligence to identify the unique check boxes, means to check the unique boxes so that it can highlight or it can identify the element. Even though if you see that there are some other values also, address bar, parent width, parent x, screen bounds, many things are there. You can do this, you can select this check boxes also. But what are the minimum attributes required for identifying the specific element is being captured by this. But you are having the privilege to change this, modify this. Okay, so the attributes, so these are the attributes which I am talking about. So these many attributes are captured, if you see here, but we need only these 5 to make the application modeler identify the specific element in a browser. So I am saying apply, so that now I will see, I'll click on highlight. So what is highlight means, you have done some capturing and you want to cross check whether it is correct or not. So you highlight will tell you what it is, means which part of the browser is being captured by the Blue Prism. So let me click on highlight and see what will happen. So this widget will close and then the part of the browser will be highlighted. So I clicked on highlight. If you see here, double block came and then wizard came again. So this is how. So think that we will remove some this. I think what I will do is I will 1, 2, 3, 4. I have removed everything and I said apply and I said highlight. So if you see here, there are 2 things getting highlighted now. What it is saying? Highlighting results more than one matching window found. So we have selected only one thing which is enabled. Means what are the enabled sections in a browser? Sorry, class name is edit. So we can, with the class name edit, what are the elements are there on the browser. So when I say highlight, so these are the ones which are enabled. So it is coming like that. It is giving a warning that when you are highlighting, saying that no specific thing is not there, there are multiple things which are covered under the selection you have done. So revisit your attribute selection, that's what it's trying to say. So what I will do is, I will again keep all this and then say apply, and I will say highlight. Now it is, see, only one is getting highlighted. So this is what is called as spying, right? And then these are the attributes, right? And then in our next video, we will see how we can use this spying, and then how we can enter the browser URL, how you can capture the HTML element. We will see it in the next video. Hope you have understood. Keep watching our videos. Keep learning.